Hello and good morning to all. Welcome to your computer class. We are learning our second chapter, Functions and Charts in MS Excel. And it is the fourth part of our chapter. Till now, in this chapter, we have discussed about the definition of function. Then, in the previous classes, we have discussed about three types of functions. Arithmetical, statistical and string function. Today, in this class, we have to discuss about the logical functions, and then we have to learn the concept of cell referencing. Now let's start. Well, in logical functions, we only have to learn one function because we only have to deal with this one function, that is f. This f is a very big and a very important tool of MS Excel. Generally, for taking any kind of logical decision in any spreadsheet program, we have to use this if function only. In general, whenever we talk about this if term, it deals with two conditions. These conditions are with true and false values. Now let's read and discuss. It returns one value if the condition is true or another value if the condition is false. Fine. So as per this definition, in this if function, we have three arguments. Our first argument is our criteria or the condition. Our second argument is the true value. And our third argument is the false value. Fine. Here, with the if condition, we have to pass a condition. If this given condition is true, then our function will directly move to the true part and it will skip the false part. But if this criteria is false, in that case, it will directly jump to the false part and it will skip the true part. Fine. So it means it has three arguments, but at a time, it can only work with two arguments. Fine. Now we have to discuss the use of this function with the help of a practical. So now let's see what we can do. Well, here we have a very simple spreadsheet that we have used earlier. Fine. Now we have some values given over here. So first we have to add these values and then we have to calculate some results on the basis of the given conditions. Fine. So here we have to calculate the sum. For calculating sum, we can use sum function. We can write equals to sum. And then we have to select all these cell ranges. Then we have to close the bracket and we have to press the enter key. Here our sum is 301. Fine. Our first condition is if sum is more than 250, then we have to print good. Now let's see. For writing the solution of this condition, we have to write equals to if, then we have to pass our logical test, that is our condition. So here we have to write if the values in cell D, so we will write if D2 is more than 250, then we have to put a comma and double quotes we will write good. We have to close the double quotes, then again we have to put a comma, then we have to write our false condition, that will be bad. Fine. That's it. Now we have to press the enter key. As you can see, our value is 301. So it means it is not equals to or it is not less than 250. So that's why our answer will be good. Fine. And we have got the correct answer over here. Our second is if sum is less than 500, then print bad. So for this, we have to write equals to if. Inside brackets, we have to select this cell. Then we have to write more than 500, comma. In double quote, we will write good. Comma, in double quote we will write bad. Then we have to close the bracket and we have to press the enter key. As you can see, this time we got the result as bad because our given condition is false. Fine. We have written the condition as D2 is more than 500 and this condition is false for this given value. Fine. So this is the use of our if function in MS Excel. Now let's suppose I am changing some values. Instead of this 13, I have a value as, let's say, 99, and over here we have a value as 125. Fine. And suppose we have here as 130. So if we do so, you can see now our values are changed. The sum is 587, and that's why the result of this statement also changed automatically. Fine. So this happens generally in MS Excel. If you change any value, it also affects your functions and formulas. Fine. Now let's move to our second concept. After this, our second concept is cell referencing. In general, Whenever we are discussing about a MS Excel sheet, we have to work with the cells, rows and columns. Fine. So in our MS Excel, every cell has a unique address, and that cell address is termed as cell reference. Fine. So a cell reference, we can say that is also termed as a cell address. This cell address is an alphanumeric value which is used to identify a specific cell in a spreadsheet. Okay. As you can see that over here, we have selected the cell A1 and the address of the cell A1 is written over here. Fine. It is written over this side. Now, this cell address has two things. It has a letter and a number. So, each cell reference contains one or more letters followed by a number. The letter or the letters identifies the column number, whereas rows represent the row number. Fine. So, it means if in the address we have A1, so this A1 represents column A and row 1. Fine. Suppose we are dealing with this particular cell. So, for this particular cell, our reference will be D8. Fine. Because our column is D and our row is 8. Fine. Now, these cell referencings are of three types. In MS Excel, we have three types of cell referencing. First is termed as relative cell reference, second one is termed as absolute cell reference, and the third one is termed as mixed cell reference. Fine. Our first one is relative cell reference. In relative cell referencing, when we copy a formula with relative cell reference, the address of the cell which are used in that formula also changes depending on the change in the cell. Fine. Suppose you have written something on a particular cell. Now you are copying that text to some other cell. So the references or the addresses of the cells will also be changed. For example, if in a cell we have written a formula as equals to A1 plus B1 and now we are copying that formula to row 2. So if we will shift that formula to the second row, the formulas will automatically change. Fine. Well, don't worry. We will discuss this practically after this. Fine. Then our second referencing is absolute cell referencing. In absolute cell referencing, generally when we do not want to change the references while copying them, in that case, we can use absolute cell reference. An absolute cell reference has a dollar sign along with the column letter and the row number. The example is over here. If a cell having formula this equals to $A$1 plus $B$1, if we are copying this in any other row, the reference will not change. Fine. Or the formula will remain the same formula. Fine. Then our next referencing is, or the last referencing is, mixed cell referencing. In this mixed cell referencing, when we have to change only one of the given reference, it means we only have to change either row or column, in that case we can use mixed cell referencing. Well, in the mixed cell referencing, for making any column or row absolute, we have to use a dollar sign before that particular row or column. So it means here we don't have to put the dollar sign before both the references. We only have to put the dollar sign either before a row or before a column. For example, if we want to write this particular reference A$3, in this A$3, this A will be relative, whereas this 3 will be absolute. It means on copying this formula, this A will change, but this 3 will remain absolute. Fine. Now we have to discuss the same thing practically. Let's see. Now, let's suppose in this particular spreadsheet, we have to calculate the sum of first 3 numbers. So for that, we are using a formula now. I am writing equals to A1 plus A2 plus A3. Fine. And then I press the enter key. We have got the sum as 75. Fine. Now let's suppose I'm copying this. Fine. I've clicked this one and now I'm copying this one. Fine. If I copy this and paste it to the next cell, the references will change and our result will also change. As you can see now, after copying this particular thing, our references have changed. Earlier we were using A1, A2, A3, but now these have changed to A2, A3 and A4. Fine. That is changed because we have shifted to one cell downward. Fine. Now let's suppose we have some numbers over here. These numbers are, let's say, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. Fine. Now let's suppose I am copying this reference from this cell to this side. Fine. If I will do so, the formula will change. Let's see what will happen. As you can see, now our formula again changed automatically on copying this, and it is now B1, B2, B3. Fine. So it means if you are using a relative cell reference, your addresses will automatically change. Fine. Now let's suppose in this cell I have written equals to A1. Fine. So as you can see, I have written equals to A1, so it is showing me the value of cell A1. I am dragging it down, it is showing me the value of cell A2 now. Fine. Now let's suppose I am dragging it once again, so it is already changing the formulas. Fine. Now let's suppose you don't want to change this particular formula. Now if in case you don't want to change any formula, then you have to put a dollar sign before that. So you will write equals to $A$1. Fine. Now when you will do so, and if you will change it, copy it now, the references will not change. As you can see, the references are the same now. Fine. So it means if you will put any dollar sign, the references will remain absolute, or they will remain same. Now let's suppose we are removing the dollar sign before A. Fine. It means now this A is relative, whereas this one is absolute. Fine. Now if we will copy this over here, it will remain same because we are not changing our row. Fine. Now suppose we are copying the same over here. So you can see that the value changed. Well, in this value, the column is changed, but the row number is similar. Fine. So it is the use of our relative cell referencing. Now, this is all for today. In the next class, we have to discuss about the concept of chart and the uses of chart in the MS Excel spreadsheet. Thanks for watching. Stay healthy and stay safe. If in case you have any doubts or queries, you can comment down all your doubts and queries in the comment section.